Okay, I've pushed the record button. This is Ham Radio Now, episode number 422. I should change the title. This is like Field Day 2020 teaser. It's a teaser show. I think in the old days, we would have called it a bull session. I'm still calling it a numbered episode. Hi, Jim.
Hey, David.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, happy something Sunday. Just
happy Father's Day.
Oh, thank you. And happy Father's Day. And happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there, too. Hopefully, they'll even listen on Father's Day. But you know, who knows? So, another Field Day episode. We're getting excited. I'm excited. You excited?
I'm thrilled. This is the first one in a couple of years. And all kinds of good things to come from it.
And been getting ready?
Got antennas tweaked up. Got my vertical working again. May throw up another vertical through the week just to play around with things. I want to try everything: horizontal, the vertical, the diagonal.
Very nice. I've been getting stuff ready. I got a bigger pile than I had last week over here on the side of my side of the shack. Just getting ready, getting stuff. Actually, even went and borrowed a radio just so.
Goodness.
Well, I don't have any. 2 meter, 70 centimeter single sideband stuff yet, but I don't either.
I guess I'd have to do a transverter on the flex, and maybe another project.
Yep. So I borrowed one because it wasn't doing anything anyways, and that particular friend of mine, he's gonna just work FM from the house because that's just the way it is right now in Los Angeles.
That'll work.
Yeah. Okay. Absolutely. We're hoping to work him. So Field Day plans. So this is a teaser because we're hoping that you're gonna get out and play some Field Day, because, you know, what else are you going to do next weekend in quarantine, right?
Well, enjoy not a contest.
Right, enjoy not a contest. And we're going to say that a bunch of times, because we're going to start talking about points. Wait, if we have points, is it a contest? I don't get it. It's a test.
It's a survey. It's a poll.
Right. It's an exercise. That's the way I like to think about it. This is the what you could you do if you had to do it. Actually, that's not even true. This is what you could do, and you're going to do it. Because why not? It's there. You got the equipment. You can drag it outside. Or you can even just sit at your regular shack and work from there. And it'll be a great weekend where everybody else will be working. And hopefully all the really good contest folks will take pity on people like me.
Well, yeah, I think there's going to be much less ownership and much, the good thing, you know, when I've gone to Field Day before, you get there. All right. Everybody's got to get their stuff set up at 11 o'clock. We're going on the air at noon, and who's on shift on the 20 meter logging tent and all this kind of stuff. So a lot of the pressure goes away. Everybody, this is a great equalizer, if nothing else.
Yep.
It's, you know, you're on your own. Can you log yourself? Do you get it? If you don't get it, sit back, get the cadence and figure it out.
Absolutely. So, things to think about in this not a contest. Points. That's a weird segue.
Points. Well, there's all kinds of ways to get them, and we're going to try, since we're all going to be home stations, we can try to amplify that by getting off the grid. That'll be fun. There's a lot of activity doing that. We've got a couple hints going on here.
Yeah. So emergency power, that'll be a good one. It'll take you from a 1D to a 1E, right? That'll be an upgrade. And then we talked a little bit about it last time, but I'll remind everybody, radiograms. There's points there. You can send one radiogram and make 100 points. That's like 50 single sideband or CW contacts. Just sending a radiogram to your section manager or your SEC. Send a quick one with a Field Day report. You know, greetings from Field Day. There is X number of people at my site, and we're having fun. That's a report. That would be good enough. Send it off.
That's good. Yeah. I think it might add a little weight to things, convince the rest of the MCOM world, the NGO world, that we're still here and viable. If, your local Red Cross, your local served agency got a note going, well, you know, in this strange time when you guys are looking at FirstNet and digital everything and encrypted this, encrypted that, guess what? You know, my $15 radio and talking on the air, delivered this message to your voicemail or your email.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. And that is the other 100 points. So the other way you can get 100 points is 10 additional radiograms to 10 people, which would be the 10 radiograms. And again, basic field day report. And, you know, in the past, we've sent them to other operators that we know, but it was that's a great suggestion you put out, is send them to your SERV agencies to let them know, hey, this is what you're doing. You're doing an exercise, and include their information. And got to remember those radiograms, those 11 radiograms for those 200 points, they do have to leave or enter your site via RF. No, yes. No Telnet Winlink. That's not going to fly. And again, it's not a contest, so everybody will be square about that and do the right thing.
Yeah, but if you're looking for people to send them to, like in California, you go to the Cal OES website, look for the Oxcom group, the reserve group. Most everybody in the regions are hams, so you know, they will count. You know, if it ends up having to be delivered first over the air to somebody to record it on NTS or otherwise, and needs to get to your county official by email after that, at least you got it there by RF at some point.
Absolutely. In LA, our NTS group, that's a big weekend for them. They step up and they advertise, hey, you know, we're going to be on the air every several hours for whatever, to take whatever traffic, and they get slammed, and it's great practice for them. And it's a good experience for you. And I will recommend, as I do, I do send to number of the served agency folks, but I also take this opportunity once a year to send it to my out-of-state emergency contacts. And again, as I recommended in the last show, I'll recommend it again. Let your emergency out-of-state contact know that the radiogram is coming. So when they get a call from, you know, Joe or Bob or Jane Ham in their local area because the NTS traffic made it to them, that they actually gracefully and thankfully accept that message, because it could be important in an event of emergency.
Well, yeah, and not just an emergency, it could be a personal emergency. You may be stuck in your car. I had this occasion on a hilltop not long ago where a circumstance came up. I was not in good 911 coverage, and what I could get, I was on the phone. So trying to get a hold of next of kin, other friends, I got on the local UHF system and said, hey, call my wife, get her on the radio. We've got something to talk about.
There you go.
So it's all fair game. It could be your own personal health and welfare message.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And
so
I think you've got something about that, the wilderness protocol.
Yeah, we do the wilderness protocol. And one of the things I will suggest, and we've suggested, we kind of spread this countywide, and actually heard on one of the other ham radio podcasts, one that's produced up in your area, the Workbench. They were talking about doing a similar thing where they've kind of scheduled time throughout the field day contests to get on the local UHF, VHF frequencies. And we could have some real pileups. I think that would be really cool if you start. Wilderness Protocol says it's starting at 7 a.m. every 3 hours. At the top of the hour, you get on and you call or listen for 5 minutes. And obviously, we won't start at 7 because, you know, in California, we start field day at 11 a.m. So then that would mean it's starting at 1 in the afternoon and going, potentially, you could go all the way around the clock, but usually they say 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. And just, you know, get out and get on calling frequency and just call and see what you get. I know in Los Angeles, you know, there's, I listen on, you know, 14652, not a lot of traffic. But on field day, there will be some. And so, you know, get your radios out and don't sit on your, you know, on your couch in the living room. You know, get outside on a deck, on the hill, and the highest part of your property for that little section of the contest, and see, you know, see how far you can go. We actually do periodic simplex tests in our county just to see, you know, how far you can hear and who you can hear. And I'm in the middle of mapping out that exercise. So yeah. other points, media publicity, I can pronounce that, 100 bonus points for sharing with the local media, press release or other newspaper article you can submit to claim those points. There are some templates out on the ARRL site that, you know, just gives you a basic thing that you can email off to the local news And the copy of that email that you sent is your, that's your points right there. You include that. This year, not so much a public location. And that's only really A, B, and F anyways. Having a public information table, again, if you're A, B, or F, is 100 points. Satellites, if you're you work satellites, one contact, 100 points. And you actually can't claim more than one satellite contact so that they don't want you to overwhelm. Because you know, if you're really good at it, you could just work all satellite all the time. But it wouldn't give guys like me who just really don't know what they're doing an opportunity to make that satellite queue. So I think this will be my eighth field day. And for the first couple of years, I think it wasn't until our fourth or fifth. Actually, probably wasn't until our third we even really tried. And it wasn't probably until our fifth or sixth until we actually made that contact. But there's a lot that went into it. And it was a lot of fun. And then since then, we make it all the time because now we understand exactly what we're doing.
So I'd be curious what the space station is doing and whether that counts.
I think the space station doesn't, but I'm not 100% sure. And if you're interested in that, figure it out.
Look that up.
Yeah, that'll be a look it up thing. Obviously, alternative power. If you're running, you can 100 bonus points for field day groups making a minimum of 5 QSOs using non-commercial power or not petroleum generator. So usually we set up right when we get there for our field day. The way we do this is we set up right when we get there. We set up a bank of a couple solar panels on an AGM battery, and we'll let it go all afternoon. And then we'll take everything down. We'll turn off the generators, and then we'll make the five QSOs on that battery.
Cool.
And we actually video record it just so that everybody can say, hey, we're legit. So five, that's 100 points. That's pretty easy to do. The W1AW bulletin. And actually, they transmit a bulletin from W1AW, or they transmit it from K6 KPH, which I visited, I think it was last year, and a couple years before that up in Point Reyes. That's a really cool visit. And
we're gonna do that again.
Yeah.
We're gonna do a show.
Yeah, absolutely. And when I went up there, I went with cameras and everything, and the guys were like working on some problem, and I just couldn't really get them engaged the proper way. And my wife was along, and I think she probably would have let me go as long as I wanted to, but I also was trying to, like, you know, we're on family vacation and do our thing. But copy down the message, and it goes out under several different modes. It'll go CW, it'll go RTTY. So again, if you think you want to work that's 100 points for copying that message. And all you got to do is just include the body of the message. Usually it's a paragraph or so, and there's a couple of spelling errors in there, and that's so that they know you actually copied it correctly.
They seeded it.
Yeah, they did. And that's available to all classes. Educational activity for A and F stations, if you do a training class or some other formal activity, that's 100 points. If you get a government official to come and visit your site, that's 100 points. And I don't think if you make a large ruckus and the neighbor calls the cops on you and they come and visit, I don't think that actually qualifies, but maybe. That might actually qualify under the next one, which is get a representative of a served agency to come and visit you. Again, you know, your mileage may vary if the neighbors call versus if you call. But it also could include your section manager, SEC, DEC, EC, or other folks. Oh, actually, no, I guess they don't qualify. It needs to be like Red Cross, SEC, Salvation Army, police, local, fire, all those folks that you actually do serve. Sorry. Go to bonus if you have a go to station. Again, I think that's like ANF only. If you submit your logs over the web, and there's a URL for that. Let's see, I can bring that up. People can see it there. That field-day.arl.org/F. Anyway, if you do that, that's extra 50 points. Having youth, at your station, there's a whole bunch of youth points that you can get, 20 point bonus, maximum 100 can be earned by A, C, D, E, or F. but not B, for every participant 18 or under.
Cool.
And five grandkids. Yeah, and they can do at least one QSO. And I think it's like each QSO is worth a certain number of points, so that's a way to do it. This is a really good, easy one, social media points. So 100 points for promoting your field day to a general public social media platform. Do you know somebody who has maybe a Facebook group that they could advertise that on?
I wonder. Let me think.
I wonder.
Maybe the wife's sewing group.
No. I have a better one. Maybe the Elmer's group. Maybe the Ham Radio Now group. You could just go in there and advertise. And, you know, advertise, you know, what you're doing, where you're doing it, and maybe what bands you're working on. That's worth 100 points. That's like, you know, making a post, that's like a minute. And that's if you think about it, because you could probably even do it faster. What are the other points? Safety officer. That's often a role that I have filled in our Aries setup. One person, this again is only like Class A. One person is safety officer, and there's a whole checklist that they put in the package. You need to make sure, you know, the power is grounded and that the antenna is safe and that there's a tape circle around stuff and that, you know, people have hard hats and whatever. And again, if you're an A station, there's an easy 100 points. So lots of points to be had for this, not a contest, event, activity, activation. What do we call it? Got to come up with something better than not a contest.
ARRL holiday.
Holiday. Yeah, there you go. Vacation on the air. I like that. So that's points. Get some points.
So for those people who don't get a first field day to go out to with a bunch of seniors, I think our teaser here is join us for field day on Zoom.
Oh, that's right. We're going to do a Zoom. Yeah, we're going to do a Zoom. I'm going to set up a Zoom room. And we will advertise that. We'll advertise that Zoom room on in both the Elmer's and the Ham Radio Now Facebook group. Just join us, check on in, you know, quick pop in to say hey. And, you know, best for this one to probably do it from your cell phone from where you're actually operating. So we can kind of see what you're doing field day wise. And I don't know. I don't think my recording limit will let me do a whole 24 hours, but I may figure out a way to record it. And so we can do some snippets later on to share everybody's field day site. I think that would be totally cool.
Well, even if we need to take a take a nap break from 8 in the evening to 8 in the morning the next morning or something,
yep,
just to break it up a little bit. But I think it'll be a good opportunity to, okay, it could be boring just sitting here watching us work pile up if we're so lucky. But take the cell phone around and look at all the gear.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, if you're having trouble with an antenna, go take a shot of it and say, hey, you know, well, we got Elmers and helpers here. Why is this antenna not working?
Absolutely.
So it can be very interactive, just like you're at field day. Why doesn't my 40 meter dipole work? Well, let's fix that and get you back up on the air. Good.
Yeah.
Stuff like that.
Yeah. Stuff like it's laying on the ground. That's probably not going to help. Pick it up.
And I don't even think, your choice of beverage will matter because, you know, it's a private gathering. We don't have to worry about those restrictions in public parks. Just make sure your behavior is suitable.
Yep. I think that's all. Anything goes.
807s were a very, very popular glass vessel of empowerment for radio for many years.
Yeah. You know what I'm going to miss this year is the barbecue.
Yeah.
I'm going to miss the barbecue because we did some nice barbecues. But, you know, it's what it is. So so the other thing to encourage y'all that are listening is, again, it's not a contest. This is not the weekend where you got to be like 100% on your game. People are going to be willing to work, operators like me that aren't big DXers. And so they'll work with you. And, you know, again, you just got to remember your call. Hopefully you got that down. Your exchange, which is, you know, pretty easy. It's where it's, you know, what you're set up as and where you are. And as long as you can get that down, it's a pretty good exchange. And I know that there are the purists out there. And remember, purists, this is not a contest. So saying thank you and have a nice field day, I think that totally flies. This is not just a, you know, Whiskey Zero Delta Hotel Golf. I am, you know, 2 Alpha Lima Alpha X-ray, and give me your, and then just move on. This is a, you know, enjoy the contest and thanks for the exchange and all those. I think that all flies.
Well, yeah, certainly, you know, we got to be welcoming. We're trying to encourage all this activity. Everybody's saying the bands are dead. I think we're going to find out this next weekend, even this weekend, as changing antennas. The bands aren't dead.
Nope.
But the, I think the good thing about that bands are dead propagation issue is we start out with a clean slate. We don't know what the conditions are going to be. Mm-hmm. If we hear a lot of stuff, it's either because there are a lot of people, mm-hmm. Or the bands are good. And I think of note is from where you are, pay attention on which bands and who, you know, which locations you're hearing to give you that sense of the bands. Yep. And if you do that at, you know, at noon, that's kind of an odd time for some bands and good for others, bad for some. And then just watch the propagation flow through as you go through the course of time. And noon to 8 or 9 in the evening is a good good plan. Then again, Sunday morning, you find out, 40 meters is pretty wiped out by foreign broadcast at the voice end most of the morning. But then just watch, observe that that cycle change. Watch those foreign stations disappear from 7200 on. And then all of a sudden, all your regular nets and the rest of the operations are going to come into picture. And so you've got two ways of figuring out what's going on. Is anybody on the air? Yeah, it's field day weekend. Everybody's going to be on the air. So let's figure out, you know, which band works when.
Absolutely.
Get used to that. And, you know, if your vertical isn't working, you know, throw up a dipole real quick and do an AB. I think that was the biggest eye opener for me every day is having a selection of antennas between Yagi and verticals and a couple of different dipoles to just do an AB comparison and go, I'm hearing that 7 station a lot better on the vertical than I am on the dipole. Why is that? But I got to switch back to the other antenna to hear the guy in 2 land. Mm-hmm. So that's, you know, just the listening value of knowing there's all these people out there is a great sponge moment for how does RF work.
Yeah. And as you set up and that antenna doesn't work, when you get it set up and you test it the first time and it looks okay, and if you put the meter on it, that looks like it should be all right, don't just take it down. Just wait a couple hours because things will change and you'll be surprised. And hopefully happily surprised. You know, I forgot there's power multipliers too. We didn't really talk a lot about that. There's all sorts of QRP. You know, if you're 5 watts or less, that's a whole big multiplier. You actually get to multiply everything by 5. That's huge. And then there's a multiplier by 2 if you stay under 150 watts. And then over that, then you don't get anything. But you get a lot of distance, a lot of footprint. Yeah. A lot of power.
And you know, if you get into a Q-cell situation, it's not a great time to rag chew, but maybe time if you made that first that initial contact and got that that signal reading at 100 watts, ask if you can drop power to 10 watts mm-hmm. and get another reading, and you know, you might be surprised the reading's the same or you disappeared. It's a good learning moment for, you know, what's going on at that end too.
We tend to do that in the middle of the night when it's started to kind of cool off and there's not a lot of folks out there. And once you get somebody, you're like, oh, hey, let's play.
Yeah.
And cause you know what? They're in the same case, you know, they're listening, they can't hear a whole lot of folks. So once they get you, you know, try this frequency, try this power, try this, you know, it's worthwhile. It's
absolutely 75 meters is a great opportunity. Even if you're just working somebody in this or just local, a couple hundred miles away, the band is really, really quiet. There isn't a lot of competition. It's a good chance to tune up the audio, change mics, whatever you want to do, change your antennas, play around a little bit, keep you up late. You get to stay up late this weekend.
Yeah. I tried to get my kids on board with that. One of them, I think she's on board, and she told me I stay up every night late. So.
Okay.
It's all good. Hopefully so she'll
be on the air.
She's going to be the anchor.
So what bands are we going to work you on?
Hoping 80, 40, 20. I've got dipoles for all that. We had a trailer for a while and we put up a big Yagi, but it ain't happening because it's going to be a small group, if anything, because I'm actually going to end up probably working 2 Alpha with our Aries group because we did get permission to work from a secret location high atop a mountaintop. But there's only going to be like 4 of us or maybe 5 of us total. I will also bring my G5 RV, so that'll work, you know, I think that works 10 to 80. So
works everything equally poorly.
Yes, exactly. So I'm going to put that up on an extra section of coax, and that's going to be my AB test, right? You know, if I can hear you on 40 on the dipole, I may switch over to see, can I hear you on the G5 RV on 40, just because.
Good.
But that'll work the, you know, the 10, the 15, the 17, some of those other bands that we don't work a lot. I don't have antennas for. I'm still working on I got parts for a 6 meter, although somebody said they may have a 6 meter Yagi. So we'll probably work some 6 meter. Then I did borrow the UHF VHF sideband rig, so we'll probably have some of that going.
That'll be interesting to see if anybody else is soda or whatever else.
Yep. And I don't think there'll be a lot of soda operators. Some of the ones, at least in my area here, that I'd be able to work, they learned their lesson weekend before last on the UHF VHF contest. I think they were a little frustrated, and I was like, no, I'll log you. I'll put you in for the soda points too. And they were thankful of that, but a lot of people didn't understand what that whole thing was, and it's not as much good for them to log somebody who doesn't know. And there just weren't a lot of other people out there chasing. So, I think that that'll be it. I don't think we're going to do any of the, you know, I don't know. And mostly we're going to be, I think the group that we're going to have, we're mostly going to be single sideband. I can do the CW, but only if I use the converter and like get my FL Digi out. And that's kind of hit or miss. I actually did it 1 year. And it worked out okay until somebody only caught partial, and I just kept repeating my exchange over and over again, and eventually they got it. But I realized like I shouldn't probably be doing that. So
it's okay not to be a CW operator.
Yeah. So that's mostly what we're gonna do. We may play a little, try a little ready. And I'm gonna be sending my radiograms via Winlink, probably VARA. I might try VARA HF, but at least VARA FM for sure, because I know I'll be able to hit an RMS gateway from there. And what about you? Where are you gonna work?
Well, I may be nostalgic for my dad used to like 15,
mm-hmm.
So something I haven't explored in a while. So maybe for him, I'll do that. One of the things I try to do every year, whether I'm really activating, you know, running field day or not, is contact my original radio club back in Wisconsin. It was a big time field day operation when I was growing up. So it'd be, you know, kind of fun to hunt them down and catch them on multiple bands for nostalgia. So, you know, a little bit of a goal, maybe a couple guys in Texas, I know, just to, so I got a target.
Cool.
So we've got, we've been invited to field day with a couple of groups in Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
So we may have to do that virtual. So Kevin and a couple of those guys from the Bristol, Tennessee area will probably pop up on Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
He said, you know, the Airstream's welcome. And I said, well, it'd take me a week to get there.
Yeah.
Just to set up and operate the radio for 2 days. I'll join you virtually. And that's one of the things that, and I'm going to share this out with one of the RVer groups as well. There are a lot of hams and RVs that are doing field day every day of their life as they rove around the country.
Mm-hmm.
So that's we've got a lot of moving targets in that group too.
Right. So it's something you can look forward to in retirement.
Yeah, well, part of it is, if not field day at a different place in the country, to schedule a summer vacation, drop in on whatever local ham club meeting mm-hmm. happens to be wherever we are and go, Elmer's on the road, look out.
Yeah, there you go. And maybe someday, I know we talked about a couple years back, we talked about field day on Pismo Beach.
Yeah.
Yeah, someday.
Yeah, we got a bunch of people meet halfway and just go to the state park there. Might be a little more amenable right next to the beach than one of the private campgrounds, so I can dry camp.
There you go.
And it's field day, so I have to dry camp.
Right? Yeah, exactly.
We'll bring a truckload of batteries down.
Yeah, there you go. And it'll be fun. All right, anything else we need to cover, remind people, get them out there for?
Be safe, have fun.
Oh, yes, that's the most important part I forgot. And I added that to the list. Have fun.
Have fun.
Have fun. Because if you're not having fun, have fun. Because we want you to come back and do it every year. Because it won't be, if it's not fun, And I know I've seen guys at our field day sites that aren't having fun, and that's been my opportunity to like figure out, well, how would it be fun for you? And we try to make it fun. And some of them even come back after we have some fun.
Well, creepy crawlies and mosquitoes and bad weather sometimes. You know, I've done the drippy wet canvas tent thing on field day, as well as too many mosquitoes to see the key. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah, that wouldn't be fun. Weird. That would not be fun. I've got to, I'm going to have to figure out. Yeah, I think we're not going to have any of that. And if we do, we'll figure it out. We'll pull it inside the RV. I think we might have an RV, so we'll pull it inside of that if we get there. Run the antennas out the window.
Yeah. You'll get it.
Cool.
We're going to have fun.
We are going to have fun. So, reminder, post in the groups what you're doing, where you're doing it, and remember, those are points. That's 100 points for a Facebook post, right? You know. And look for the Zoom information, and I'll probably put it out Friday afternoonish, maybe sooner. Look for the links for the Zoom, and just hop in and come visit and say hey, or ask a question, or do it on your cell phone and brag about your awesome field day setup, because we want to see that, and that's useful, and that's really, hopefully it will be an opportunity to inspire others for next year to think, oh, wow, look what they did. That's totally awesome. We want to do that.
I can do that. My neighbor's got a camper. I can borrow that.
Exactly.
The kids want to go camping this year. Whatever, fun.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And yeah, I think I'll do a poll on Elmer's group just to kind of build up to who knows what field day is, who thinks you're going to do something for it, and just kind of build on some data collection there and get people engaged, get people thinking about it.
Excellent. Excellent. Okay. Well, I think that will wrap it up today. Remember, Ham Radio Now is here for you. It's free for you to watch. It's not free for me to make. So if you like what we're doing, visit hamradionow.tv, click the pig, find Arvin, help support us a little bit. It does cost me a little bit every year to host it and get equipment and whatever. So whatever you can do to help out, that's great. I think that's it. Thanks for joining me, Jim. And I look forward to working you on field day. I think I think we'll be able to make that happen across several different bands.
Everyone. Worked all, David.
Woo! Hopefully we can do as many as we can. And I hope to work a bunch of you out there in the audience as well. And if you're too far out and our setup isn't good enough for that, I just hope you work a bunch of folks out there and then have fun.
Have fun.
Thanks for joining us. I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG. And you're?
Jim Aspinwall, NO1PC.
We'll say over and
out.
Awesome.